bless everybody this morning. We praise God for each one of you. Amen. Come on, give God some praise. It's time to give God glory and praise. Come on. Come on, let us see your face. Come on, give God some glory. Give God some praise. We're starting our Sunday morning worship service at the Solid Rock Church of God in Christ, Newark and Tracy. Amen. So we praise God for all of you. Praise and worship is getting ready to get started. Amen. We're going to go forward today and enjoy the Lord together. Is that all right? Now, that means if you feel like shouting, you get to run around the room. Glory to God. You feel like clapping your hands, clap them real loud. Amen. And you might not be able to touch your neighbor, but you can write in the chat box, I am gloriously blessed by the Lord. Amen. Yes. God bless you all. Praise and worship begins right about now. Praise God.
Can you hear, Pastor?
You know we can't hear.
Yes, sir.
Can't hear nothing, sir.
I know.
I know, we can't hear either.
You cannot hear.
Oh, get the glory out of my life. Oh, Lord, get the glory. Lord, get the glory. Oh!
Let
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Missionary Green will come with our prayer. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Good morning, church. All minds clear. Father God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for a day that we have never seen before. We thank you for the opportunity to wake up this morning and to give you glory and to recognize who you are and what you are to our lives. Lord, we thank you for our families. We thank you for our leaders. We thank you for our cars. We thank you for our hands. We thank you for our feet. We thank you for all the activities of our limbs. Lord, we thank you for covering us in your blood. Lord, we thank you for everything that you're doing and what you are going to, what you are about to do in our lives and in our communities. And Lord, we want to be the servants that you have called us to be. Lord, you have heard our petitions early this morning. You have heard our petitions early this morning. And Lord, let us be who you have called us to be. Lord, let the petitions that have gone before you be filled as you see fit. Lord, we all want to be what you have called us to be. Lord, help us. Help us to be what we were supposed to be. Help us to be what you have called us to be. Help us to understand the assignments that we have on our lives that you have appointed us to be. And Lord, let our light so shine that men see our good work. Let our light so shine that that others want to say, what do I need to do to be saved? Lord, let our life call so that somebody else can want to be saved and be a part of this ministry. Lord, let us be examples of all. Let us be examples of all. And Lord, we ask that if we know that there's things that are in us that are not like you, we ask you to take it out. We ask you to take it out. Lord, create in us a clean heart. Lord, create in us a clean heart and renew the right spirit in us. Lord, we ask this in your son Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen.
Amen. I'll be reading for your hearing Psalms 138, starting at verse number 1. I will praise thee with my whole heart. Before the gods will I sing praise unto him, thee. I will worship toward thy holy temple and praise thy name for thy loving kindness and for thy truth. For thou hast magnified thy word above all thy name. In the day when I cried, thou answerest me and strengthenest me with strength in my soul. All the kings of the earth shall praise thee, O Lord, when thou hear the words of thy mouth. Yea, they shall sing in the ways of the Lord. For great is the glory of the Lord. Though the Lord be high, yet he respect unto the lowly. But the proud he knoweth afar off. Though I walk in the midst of trouble, thou wilt revive me. Thou shalt stretch forth thy hand against the wrath of my enemies, and thy right hand shall save me. The Lord will perfect that which concerneth me. Thy mercy, O Lord, endureth forever. Forsake not the works of thine hands. God have a blessing to the reading and doing of his word. God bless you. Now we will have a musical selection by Sister Ashley Jimson. Thank you. God, amen. That the song says, just stand on his word, stand on the promises of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. At this time, we will have a welcome and invitation to worship by our dear brother, James Romero.
God bless you, everybody, here at the Solid Rock Churches of God in Christ. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. we bid you welcome to the Solid Rock Churches of God in Christ, where our pastor is the elder and superintendent, Pastor Gerald K. Simpkins, along with our lovely First Lady, the Jewel of the Rock, Sheila Ann Simpkins, and all of the Churches of God in Christ, Solid Rock Churches of God in Christ church family, both in Newark and in Tracy. We bid you welcome, and we ask that you come in with a heart ready to worship God, to love God, to praise Him, to give Him thanks for all He's done for us all week long. If there are anyone who is wanting to know how to get in contact with us, I'm sure that there will be information scrolling in the announcements at some point during the service. But nevertheless, we welcome you. We thank you for your time, and we are honored by your presence. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
God bless you. Thank you so much, Brother Romero, for that wonderful welcome and invitation to worship. Amen. At this time, we will go further into our service. Amen. How many know God has been good to us? God has truly been good to us. At this time, there's going to be a few individuals that are going to come forth and tell us how good God has been to them. Amen. At this time, we will have Sister Malika Gardner to come. After her, Missionary Robin Smith. After Missionary Smith, Brother Billy Sandy. Then Deacon Jimmy Hooker. Sister Tracy Reed, and my daughter. God bless you.
Good morning, everyone. I just want to say that God has been beyond good to me and my family, and I'm super blessed and grateful and just thankful for it all. Thankful for my pastor for keeping on me and for God's mercy and grace.
Amen. Praise God. I am thankful and grateful and ever so, so happy and encouraged for God being who He is. And He is my all in all. Amen.
Brother Sandy.
Amen, amen. I'm grateful and thankful today just to be walking. I'm grateful that God woke me up this morning. I am so grateful and have so many things to be grateful and thankful for. Amen.
Amen. I thank God today for waking me up with a sound mind. I thank for my health and my strength, my wife, my pastor, Gerald K. Simpkins, and his wife, Sheila Ann Simpkins, the Church of God, the saints of God everywhere, and especially my church home. Amen.
Praise the Lord, saints. First, giving honor to God, I am so grateful and thankful for life itself. In spite of what's going on and what we see around, I am just grateful that God allowed me to be here again today. I'm thankful for my family, my husband, and I am so grateful to have great leaders like Pastor Simpkins and our Jewel of the Rock First Lady and all our saints of Solid Rock Valley and Newark. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you all for those wonderful testimonies. God has truly been good to us. Amen. As we go into our next musical selection, how many of you know God is indeed keeping you? God bless you.
You to know that.
Somebody ought to give God some praise. Listen, so whoever's running this thing, would y'all just unmute and let everybody just give God some praise? Aren't you glad that God is keeping you? Come on, amen. Clap your hands right where you are. Unmute this
amen,
thing.
Amen,
let everybody
amen,
clap their hands. Hallelujah. I'm so
grateful.
You're talking about community in Sunday school, but this is a community of praise. Amen. This is
yes.
This is an action, an active community. And we praise God for each one of you today. Amen. We enjoyed all that has gone before. Thank God for the prayer. Thank God for the scripture. Amen. We praise God. Sister Ashley blew that horn. Amen. We praise God for the anointing on her life. Some folks are gifted and talented, and some folks is anointed. Amen. We thank God for the anointing on her life. Thank God, amen, for those who express their appreciation in this Thanksgiving season. Amen. Sometimes when we're going through what we're going through, we forget about the fact that it's God that has kept us in the midst of our difficulties. It's God that we worrying about the difficulty. No. Give God praise for keeping us in this thing. Glory to God. And knowing that all things are working together. Somebody ought to finish that sentence right where you are. Glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Are working together. For my good.
Yes.
For my good. They might not see Father good, God. But they have an assignment, and that is to work together for my good. Amen. So we praise God for each one of you today. Amen. And we're going to move on to honor the Lord for all of the elders that are online, all the ministers, the deacons, glory to God, First Lady, the mothers, all of the women of God, every one of you all. Amen. We honor the Lord for everybody. Amen. That has made up, amen, this assembly of worship and praise this morning. Listen, I want to just share with you a little bit as we move forward. Our announcements have run, and they're going to run again in just a few minutes, and I want you all to pay attention. But right now, let me do this. Let me encourage all of us to get ourselves prepared to worship the Lord in the ministry of giving. Amen. With the ministry of giving. Now, you right in where you are, shout by faith. Glory to God, right where you are. Glory to God, sitting in your room, in your car, on your job, wherever you are, declare, I'm sowing by faith. Amen. I'm sowing by faith. Amen. That's how we live this thing. The Bible says, without faith, it is impossible to please the Lord. For they that come to the Lord must first believe that he is God, and that he's a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Let me read a familiar passage of scripture. It says, but this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. And he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully in abundance. So let each one give as he proposes in his heart. We talked about that today. Glory to God. He said, glory to God, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. And then check this promise out. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you always, having all sufficiency in all things, may have an abundance for every good work. Glory to God. Lord, give us a promise. Tell us when we sow with the right heart, not of compulsion, glory to God, but because God loves a cheerful giver, God will make sure that everything you need all the time will always be there. Everything you need all the time will always be there. Glory to God. So get your best seed together. Those of us, we know the Bible tells us to tithe. Amen. Tithe is the tenth of our increase, not just your salary, but your increase. Amen. And so we ask you to sow your tithe. Amen. And then give your free will offering. The tithe is giving back to God what's already his. The free will offering, that donation is your sacrifice. That's your sacrifice. Some God will tell sacrifice 100. Some will say, God will say sacrifice 25. Some God will say sacrifice 1,000. Whatever it is, amen, you sacrifice. That's your sacrifice. Amen. So we praise God for each one of you today. Glory to God. And you can give, of course, with Givelify. And you can give, amen, with the Cash App. Glory to God. And, of course, you can give with PayPal. And you can mail in your seed to Solid Rock Church of God in Christ, 5970 Thornton Avenue in Newark, California. That's headquarters, amen, in Newark, 94560. Glory to God. So we praise God for each one of you who faithfully sow your seed. And I know that God, the Holy Spirit, is moving on your heart right now. Amen. And I got to tell you, if you need something, sow into it. If you need something, sow into it. And watch God answer that prayer. God's keeping you, amen, and meeting all of your needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. God bless all of you all, amen. The announcements are going to be running now, glory to God, and I would pray that everybody would take note of those things that are going on, amen. I need to tell you that every day of the week, amen, Monday through Friday, I should say, glory to God, there are prayer. There is prayer going on, and you need to know, amen, God wants this house to be a house of prayer. We have been praying, and I want to thank God for those who, not only the leaders, I thank God for them, but those who have joined them on a regular basis, glory to God, amen. Come on back to the announcements, on a regular basis to be a part of the prayer ministry Monday through Friday, amen, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 12 noon, and Tuesday and Thursday at 6 a.m. in the morning. Glory to God. Glory to God. Our youth Bible study and our adult Bible study takes place on Tuesday nights. Amen. At 7 o'clock, we gather for prayer, and then we have prayer, and this is the time when we have a little testimony service. Glory to God. Folks is kind of getting out of that testimony, but you, the Bible says we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony, and so you need to do that. The men cave come together on the second and fourth Monday nights. Glory to God. I want to encourage you all to be a part of that. We have been having a wonderful gathering talking about mental health among men. The wives ought to clap your hands and say amen to that. Mental health among men. Amen. And so we're coming together on the Monday, every second and fourth Monday nights for that. Glory to God. I do want to encourage you, Fresh Bread is going to be on Thursday at 10 a.m. I ask you to just come and join us for an inspirational, empowering, and relevant word. It's Fresh Bread. Just 10 minutes and you'll be blessed. Listen, Thursday is Thanksgiving. Thursday is Thanksgiving. Amen. And we're going to have a wonderful time. Stay right there, brother. We're going to have a wonderful time. Amen. In Thanksgiving, on Thanksgiving, we're appreciating God for how good he's been. But that night, we're going to come together for a Thanksgiving revival. Amen. After you eat all the turkey and all the lobster and all the lamb chops and all the chicken, whatever it is, amen, we're going to have, amen, a revival that night. Opening up is going to be Pastor Overseer Renee Winston, amen. And then on Friday night is going to be Apostle D. Dwayne Christmas. Amen. It's going to be miracles. You need to come looking for a miracle, looking for a breakthrough. Glory to God. And that's going to take place. This is our Thanksgiving revival. Our district is pulling that together. Amen. The Sweet Unity District. The Sweet Unity District. And now district missionary is Mother Lonnie Barker. Amen. The pastors, Pastor Henry Kelly, Pastor, our assistant superintendent is Pastor Leon Swindell, Pastor, glory to God, Jerry Waters, and Pastor Albert Thomas. Amen. We all come together to make up the Sweet Unity District. So I encourage all of you to come on, be on this particular Zoom line. Come on and join us. Amen. Glory to God. I want to encourage you all that next Sunday, praise God for Mother McCoy and the Mother's Board. I've got to say amen to them because the Mother's Board works hard. And every year they are pulling this thing together and they have bless the church. Matter of fact, the new parking lot that we have there in the back of the church, our new parking lot, Mother Nim sold tremendously into making that come to fruition. Those ladies was tired of tearing up the heels of their shoes and broken asphalt. Amen. And we put in, glory to God, with the help of the Mother's Board and of the support of Mother's Pew Rally. Amen. Which will take place next Sunday, the 29th at 2:30. Next Sunday, the 29th at 2:30. My friend is going to be ministering, Pastor Terry Johnson from Courts of Praise there in Manteca. Amen. Very faithful man who supports, he and his wife support everybody. And so we praise God. Now, this is what we're asking you to do. You give $12 and we're asking you to ask 11 more folks to give $12. That means you'll have brought in or blessed the church with $144. It's easy to ask folks for $12. Amen. As a matter of fact, they'd be glad to give you that. Glory to God. So we praise God for that. And we're looking forward to you joining us after the main service next Sunday at 2:30. God bless you. Bless you all. Amen. I'm not sure. So school supplies. Yes. The church has a ton of school supplies, which we receive from stores that donate to us, to our missions department. And so we're asking you all to make sure that you connect, come by. If you need some binders and all of those kinds of things, you can do that. If you know somebody that needs those, amen, please let us know and let Missionary Burnett know or Sister Stevenson, and they will make sure you get that. This one more thing, and then I'm gonna move on. That's enough announcements. One more thing, this is very important. On Thanksgiving, amen, we want to be a blessing to others. I said, we want to be a blessing to others. So we're asking you, and you need to do it by today, amen. You need to do it by today. Turn in three names, up to three names, if you desire. Amen. If you know somebody that needs a blessing, both here in the valley, amen. And I don't need to say that anymore. Anything we do for Solid Rock is for Solid Rock, wherever you are. Who knows where God will open up another. But in any event, we need you to turn in those names so we can get them a turkey and a basket of food. Amen. And we're going to have you come pick it up and deliver it personally. It's going to be a personal delivery. It's going to come. Solid Rock is going to bless them, but we're going to bless them through you. Who knows whether or not that will be the witness you can use to ask them to come to Christ or to reconnect in their relationship with God. Is that all right? All right. God bless everybody today. Please make sure that you let Sister Stevenson. No, you can put it in the chat box. Glory to God. You can put your name in. Sister Stevenson will pick that up. Amen. And she'll be able to connect with you. Glory to God, to get those three names of individuals that you want to be a blessing to. Amen. Amen. I praise God for every one of you today. We have had a wonderful service. This has been fantastic. We've enjoyed ourselves. And we are getting ready to hear the word of the Lord. First Lady Simpkins is a tremendous woman of God. I've got to tell you that for these 22 years that we have done ministry, my wife has been at every turn. She has supported me. She's allowed me to spend her money. Glory to God. She's encouraged me. She's given me guidance and direction and help, as she should, because that's why God gave her to me, to help me. Amen. To meet the needs of the people of God. Amen. And God sent her to me. Glory to God. When we had no idea we would be doing anything like this. Amen. So God said, you got to leave Florida. You got to go to California, because there's a fella out there who's going to be doing a church in some years, and he's going to need your help. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. So I praise God for all of you all that are here. And after we have heard, after we have saw, watched the next praise dance presentation by our dear friend and daughter, amen, Sister Tracy Sovereign, amen, Sister Tracy Sovereign, amen. There will be a presentation, and after, when she gets through, the next voice you'll hear be that of that lovely lady. Glory to God, on my screen, she's sitting in the corner, but that lovely lady, the lady Sheila Ann Simpkins, amen. Would you clap your hands right now and receive the presentation, and then First Lady Simpkins.
The atmosphere is changing. Nothing stays the same. Heaven is waiting for the mention of the name. The Spirit is moving, burning like a flame, healing the broken by the one we proclaim. Raise it up, fill the sky, chains will. Mountains move, we lift him high. Speak the name above all other names. Speak the name the wind and waves obey. All of heaven's coming down, fill the earth with the sound. Hostages of shame, miracles unfolding at the mention of the name. Now darkness is fleeing, mercy raining down, healing waters flowing as our lips make the sound. Raise it up. The name above all others. strongholds are broke. I've been made free. I am forgiven. Fear has to leave. Strongholds are broken. I've been made free. I am forgiven. Fear has to leave. Your name is healing. Your name is power. Your name is holy. My strong, strong power. Wonderful name. Glorious name. Powerful name of Jesus. Jesus, be the name above all other names. Be the name the wind and waves obey. All the heaven coming down, fill the earth with the sound of the name of Jesus.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. What a beautiful song. The name of Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. It brings me straight into the message that I'm going to be speaking today. But first of all, I want to give honor to God today. He is my everything, and I love him truly. Giving honor to my pastor today, giving honor to all of the elders that are on the line today, giving honor to all the mothers that are on the line today. I don't want to start calling names because I don't want to leave anybody out, but I do want to say that I am so grateful to be here today. I am so honored in my spirit, in my heart, to be before you today. Oh my goodness, I'm excited. I'm so excited about the word of God. Amen. Again, that was a beautiful name, a beautiful song that we just heard. But as we move forward, I will not hesitate. I will not be before you long, but I am going to give to you what the Lord has given to me. I prayed about it. I thought about it. And here it is. My theme for my title for today is The Power of God's Word. Hallelujah. The power of God's words. Now we know for a fact that the word is powerful anyway. Coming out of different people's mouths, they say different things to us, but we cannot receive those things that are not right. Amen. By being in the church, I have learned to say, I rebuke that right now in the name of Jesus. So if anybody speak any ill things over your life, hallelujah, I want you to rebuke it. Don't wait till tomorrow. Don't focus on it. Don't even digest it. Let it go and say, I rebuke that right now in the name of Jesus, because we know that our Lord and Savior only has good things for us. Hallelujah. God bless you all. I love you all. I just thank God for my solid rock family who is here to support me. For anyone who might be visiting or here, I give honor to you today. All right, as I begin, the power of God's word. I am going to be coming from the scripture, directly from the scripture today, because I want you to know where these scriptures are in the word. And I know a lot of you say, oh, First Lady, I already know all of that. Wonderful. Wonderful. I am so happy that you know it. But just consider this as just a little refreshing course. As we sit in the houses that we're in now or wherever we are, and we watch the news, we see so many people in lines and lines and lines waiting for food. Amen. People are losing their homes and losing their jobs. It's just detrimental. But I do know, saints, the power of God's word. And we are going to speak prosperity over them. Amen. I don't care how it's going. I know God is still taking care of many of us through this pandemic that we're going through, but it's not all about us. Oh, no, no, no. It's about everybody. So we have to pray for everyone. Amen. The power of God's word. You know, as I think back over my life, even before I gave my heart to the Lord, I finally realized that God was there with me all the time. Has it happened to anyone else? Do you realize that God is with you all the time? When you're good, he's with you. When you are bad, he's with you. He is there watching over you and protecting you from things that you see and things that you can't see. Wow. What a wonderful Savior we have. What a wonderful God we have. He watches over all of us, and he is protecting us from our foolish ways. And we do all have foolish ways. Amen? Even when we're saved, sometimes we kind of fall to the side or whatever. But we know God is still there. Hallelujah. And we thank him for that today. And one thing I love about God, even before I had any knowledge of his word, he was still there because he has a plan for each and every one of us. It reminded me of what my husband said when I was way down there in Quincy, Florida, a little bitty country town with the whites on one side and the blacks on the other. The Lord had a plan for me. He brought me all the way across the world, all the way across to meet this man that I have married today. And I did not know that we were doing what we would be doing today, but I thank God for it. And I consider it an honor and a privilege. Amen. God is so good. You know, so often we feel that we are waiting on God to come and do something great for us. You know, well, I'm just waiting. Yes, there are some things we do have to wait for, but we also have to know that he is always there with us. And he is waiting on us to do what we need to do so we can get in line with what he wants us to do. He will let us run around and do different things or whatever, but when it's time to bring us in, oh, we have to come in, amen? And sometimes we have to suffer it to be so. But I thank God because he knows what is best for us when we are saved and whether we are not. Thank God we all belong to him. He is our Heavenly Father. He watches over us. And I thank God. First of all, we must come to a place to surrender our hearts, our minds, and our soul to him. In this world, we are just passing through. Saints, so many people are dying now, the young and the old. We are not here to stay. We are just passing through. And as we pass through and as we go back, remember these old fleshly bodies here, they came from dirt and they will return right back to dirt. And you will find that in Ecclesiastes 3:20. But I got good news for you today, saints. Very good news for you. Once you surrender to God, you would have eternal life with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. All praise his name. I know y'all want to clap on that, amen? Because God is good. He has a place for us with him through all we're going through. He has prepared a place for us to be. And I thank him for that. Hebrews 4:12. For the word of God is living and active, sharper, hallelujah, sharper than any two-edged sword, discerning the thoughts and the intentions of your heart. The word is powerful. The word is life-changing. Oh my God. And I'm pretty sure for those of you who have been out there in the world, and now that you have come in, hallelujah, now that you have given your soul and your heart and your mind to him, you see a change. You see a change. And it is the power, hallelujah, it is the power of our Lord and Savior's word. Amen? We must not only listen to the word, but we must also let it shape our lives. We cannot be talking one thing and living another thing, because we are examples. Amen? When we accept Christ, we are just walking around doing what he has called us to do, because our job is to bring as many people into the kingdom as we can. We might not can't see God walking around, but you do see us, the saints of God, walking around. This is why we have the teachers and the preachers and the ministers. This is why we have the missionaries. This is why we have all of God's people. We are so important, because we have been chosen to do what God has called us to do. Live a life so that we can bring others in to him. Amen, amen, amen. And one thing about the word, saints, that I have really learned, the more and more you study this word, your hunger, your appetite for this word just become stronger for it. Amen? You just want to read it. You want to be a part of it. When you think about it, the word comes to mind. In Matthew 5:6, it said, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, because they will be filled. Bless this holy name. The hunger, oh, and you will be blessed. Psalms 34:8. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. And he is good, saints. He woke you up this morning. A lot of us have not had the cobra virus. He is good. A lot of us have had it and we have been delivered. He is good. And we thank him for that in this time, in this season. Oh my God. Again, the power of God's word. Men and women have suffered pain because of their love for God's word. Many people have been tormented. Many people have been killed because of God's word. Others have spent their whole life studying the word. Once you are called, you get that hunger to learn more and more about the word. Nearly 2,000 years after it was written, it is still changing people's lives. Isn't that awesome? It's still changing people's lives. It's changed my life, and I know that it also changed your lives. And John 1:1, it says, in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. My God. Christ, the living Word, was totally involved in the creation. John 1:3 says, all things was made by him, and without him was not anything made. Remember, saints, that you exist because God made you. Isn't that awesome? You exist because God made you. We're still here because God allowed us still to be here. And I am so happy and excited about it. Amen. The gifts that God has given to you, we already know they came from God. Amen. No matter how big or small you think your gift is, it is yours. And God gave it to you because the power, hallelujah, the power of God's word is sufficient for all of our needs. There is not a need that God cannot take care of. There is not a problem that God cannot solve for you. All you have to do is go to him and you will find the answer, hallelujah, in the powerful word of God. Oh, bless his name. Bless his name. His word comforts us, saints. When you're down and when you're out and you're not feeling good, oh my God, my scripture is in the morning when I rise, if I don't feel quite right or something is not wrong, I say, Lord, bless my day. Bless the people that are around me. Lord Jesus, touch them, Lord. And then I'll do my scripture. This is the day the Lord has made. Hallelujah. And I shall rejoice and be glad in it. That's powerful, saints. That word is powerful. So when you're feeling you're down and you're out, get you a scripture. That scripture will lift you. It will pick you up. It will comfort you. Romans 15 and 4 says, through patience and comfort of the scriptures, you might have hope. Amen? The word strengthen us to be more faithful to God. When you feel yourself kind of straying out, that's why it's so important for us to stay in the word. Because when you feel yourself kind of acting crazy, and don't say you don't. You man, because you do. Because we're human. We all kind of go to the side. But if you get you a scripture, my pastor would often say, get you a scripture and a song. Amen? And some people say, well, get you a scripture and a scripture and a scripture. But if you just got that one scripture, hallelujah, and it's powerful to you, you use it because that's your armor. That's your strength. That's what God has given to us to walk on this earth. His word, the power of his word. You speak good things over yourself. You speak wonderful things over your children. Don't tell them that they're nothing and they won't be this and they won't be that. You tell them that they can be the doctors and they can be the lawyers. They can be anything they desire to be. Speak life, saints. Speak life. Speak life. Speak life over your body. When your body started acting crazy, say, I am healed. I feel good. This is all right. Speak life. Don't let yourself just, you know, just bow down to the feelings and emotions and things that you're going to have. Sometimes I may have a pain in my leg or a pain in my arm, and I say, this is all right. It's fine. I just keep speaking life. And pretty soon I'll be up and I'll be moving around and I'll be fine. Because I am speaking life, amen? I am keeping the word, amen, in my heart and in my mind. Because I know the word keeps bringing me closer and closer to our Lord and Savior. This is why we must study the word. You cannot use what you don't have, saints. If you don't have it, you can't bring it back up. But you know what? God has made it so convenient for all of us now. We all got a phone. Hallelujah. Put that Bible app in there and bring it up. You don't even have to try to wreck your brain no more. Just bring it up. And sometimes if you can't remember the scripture, say, just say faith. Hallelujah. Put it in there and it'll bring up all the scriptures for faith. Pain, whatever you need, God has made it sufficient for us to use, to build us, to strengthen us, and keep us close to him in this time that we are in. Hallelujah. And we thank him for the technology that we have. Amen. It is so important for us to make this word a lifestyle. You know, we can't be living it today and then jumping back on it tomorrow. It's important to make it a lifestyle, not only for yourself, but for your loved ones. Because if your loved ones keep seeing you running in and out, they're gonna say you ain't got nothing. Amen? So you want them to know that God is powerful and his word is even more powerful and it has the strength to hold you and to lead you and to guide you. Psalms 119 and 11, hallelujah. Your word I have hidden in my heart that I might not sin against thee. Oh, Jesus, that's powerful, saints. Hide the word in your heart so you won't sin. Hallelujah. Some of you may have a cussing problem. Hide the word in your heart, and the Lord will clean your mouth. Ask me. I used to cuss like a sailor. Oh, Jesus. When I think back, I go, was that me? Yes, it was me. Oh, but when I hear that word in my heart, the Lord cleaned me up from the inside out. And I thank him for it. Oh, he's so wonderful. Oh, I'm just about through saying, so like I said, I won't be long. I'm just going to give what the Lord has told me to give to you. But I just want you to realize today how powerful. I know you may already know this, but I want you to know this, that God's word is powerful, especially in this time. Especially in this time, we're going to keep praying, and we're going to keep seeking him, and we're going to keep lifting him up, and we're going to keep glorifying him, because he is in control. Thank you, Jesus. God's word has the power to convert the lost. Now, I know I got some friends, and I know y'all got some too. I know one of our deacons in our church, somebody always say, you know, we can't believe you got saved because we've been one of them a long time. But I tell you, he been around a long time. He might not have been saved at that time, but while he was there, the Lord was filling him up. He knows the word. And then when he decided to come on in, boy, he came in running. Some folks, you got to push. You know, come on, baby. Come on. Not him. He came in, saw need, saw things that need to be done. You want to think the man been saved for 20 years. He's praying. He's worshiping. He's there. He's thoughtful. He's kind. And I don't give the credit to him. I give it to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Look what God has done. And just like he did it for him, he'll do it for you. He'll do it for your children. He'll do it for your loved ones. There is nobody too bad to be saved by God. His word is so powerful, saints. It's powerful. Speak it. Speak the word of God. Don't speak death. Speak life over your situation. I don't care what it looks like. I don't care what it feels like. If you can't think of nothing else to say, Jesus. You ever been driving down the road? Maybe driving down the road, almost an accident is about to happen, and you go, Jesus, my God. You see, these things happen, you know? God is there to help us and to be with us at all times, not sometimes. And then when I speak of the word, I am not talking about my word. Mm-mm. I am not talking about your word. No power, saints. These folks who think they're doing everything. Oh, I touched you and you fell out. Oh, I did this and you did this. Oh, I got all this power. You ain't got no power. Let me just tell you, if you think you are, you ain't got no power. Because if you had all the power, you'd probably be sitting on top of the moon someplace. So you don't have the power to do it. But the words of God, is able to say. It's the power, saints, of the word that does this. That's why we must have the word of God. I have no power. Oh, people fall in love with preachers and leaders. Oh, he touched me. Oh, he healed me. He did not heal you, saints. I'm sorry. I don't mean to go off. I don't mean that crazy. I don't mean to be country because I am. But I am going to tell you this. They did not heal you. We have no power. It all comes from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And believe me, saints, if somebody did heal you, just remember, God used a donkey. He used anybody to get what he want to have done. Hallelujah. Yes, he is, because he is powerful. His word is powerful to save our souls. Romans chapter 1 and 16. For I am not ashamed of the gospel. For it is the power of God to salvation for everyone who believes. You got to believe. Just like you believe when you get in your car and I say I'm going to Walmart, you got to believe the highway gonna take me to Walmart. So you got to believe God just like that, to know that he is there for you, to lead you, to guide you, and to comfort you. Amen, amen, amen. Romans 1 and 16 says, for I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God's salvation for everyone that believes. James chapter 1, verse 21, therefore lay aside all filthiness in the overflow of wickedness and receive with meekness the implanted word, which is able to save our souls. Get the word in your spirit. The word is gonna keep you. The word is gonna guide you. In sleepless nights, pick up that word, saints. You think you can't sleep? Start to read, you'll fall right to sleep. Amen? Try it, it's good. For those who are suffering with insomnia, pick up the word. Pick up the word. It's power in the word. Men, women, and children must hear the word of God preach before they can be saved. Romans 10 and 17. So then, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. God's word has the power to be the seed of the kingdom of God. Life begins with a seed for all of us. We all came from seeds. Hallelujah. Even the animals and the plants. The same is true for God's spiritual kingdom. The seed is the church. The seed is the church, saints. This is where we come when we're hurt. This is where we come when we're feeling bad. This is where we come when we lose hope. I remember years ago, a friend of ours, very close, who we love, she had cancer and she was dying. But you know where she came? She could have went anywhere. She could have went and got closed up someplace. She could have traveled away. She could have stayed home and locked herself in. But she came to the church because the church is the seed. Amen. Before she left here, she was saved. Before she left here, she felt loved. Before she left here, hallelujah, God had a plan for her. Amen. We don't understand it. We'll never understand it all. But we know that we have a God who knows the best for us, and he makes sure that we get it. Amen. Hallelujah. Matthew 4 and 4. He answered and said, it was written, man should not live by bread alone, but by every word. You hear me? We can't live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Not from Sheila Simpkins. From God. And we have to remember this, saints, that this is not a feeling walk. It ain't how I feel. It's not a feeling walk. It is a faith walk. Because sometimes you might not feel like doing nothing. But because of your faith and because of the word of God, it strengthens you to do what the Lord has called you to do. Well, I love you all. I hope you receive something from this. But I would like to add this final thing. Finally, God's word has the power to judge us on the last day. We don't know when the last day will be, but God's word has the power to judge us on the last day. You will come to regret that you rejected God's word. John 12, verses 47 through 48. And if anyone hears my word and does not believe, I do not judge him. For I did not come to judge the world, but I came to save the world. Isn't that something? I read that. I was kind of confused, but the Lord showed me, oh my God. Here in verse 48, he said, he who rejects me and does not receive my words has that which judge him. So the word, you hear me? the word that I have spoken will judge him on the last day. Now, what kind of power is that? Is that power? Is that power? The word is going to judge you. Not him, but the word of God will be judging you on that last day. Only God's word has the power to heal, to deliver, and to set you free from your sin. Only God's word has the power to do that. So today, I'm going to leave you with this scripture. And before I do that, I'm going to tell you that I love you. I thank God for each and every one of you. And I pray that I have said something to encourage you during this time and season that we're in. So for those of you who have nothing to do, pick up your word. Hallelujah. The scripture says in Psalms 107:20 says, he sent out his word and healed them and delivered them from destruction. It is so many scriptures. His word is so powerful, saints. So I'm saying to you, however you're feeling, get in the word. The word will take care of you. And we will take care of each other because God put us here to do that. I love you all. I thank you for your time. I thank you for listening. But just remember that there is power. Hallelujah. Power in the word of God. Thank you. And God bless you all.
Come on, give God some praise all over this gathering, this community. Come on, give God some praise all over this community. Hallelujah.
Wonderful.
Thank you for the word, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for the word. Listen, if there's anybody on here today and you feel like you need to just get closer to God, maybe you've drifted a bit and maybe you're not in a place that you know you should be. And as it was with Ananias and Sapphira, when that happens, the Holy Ghost is always unctioning us. And that's suggesting right. to us to get back in place with God, get in your position with God. Maybe you're out hanging out where somebody else might be, but that's not your spot in God. So if that's you today, glory to God, would you just bow your heads as we begin to pray? And amen. Let's make this confession to God. Father, we thank you now. We praise you, God, that we heard this word of power and a word that reconnects us to the power. God, touch right now every man, woman, boy, and girl under the sound of my voice. God, let the Holy Ghost prick their hearts and cause them to ask you for forgiveness and to be restored to their right place in you. Now, God, we declare it's done. You promised you would do it. God, you said if we confess our sins, you are faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And today we receive forgiveness and restoration to the place in the kingdom that you've called us to. We receive it in Jesus' name. Come on, say amen and give God a praise. Amen and amen.
Amen. Amen. Glory to God.